We begin tonight with a man behind bars following a crash in Santa Maria that killed two young women early this morning. KSBY News reporter Asia Gore was on scene and joins us more from the newsroom with more details. Asia.
Well, Dustin, two people died and a third person critically injured. The driver of the other vehicle now suspected of driving under the influence of alcohol.
It was like an explosion. It was at 3 o'clock in the morning and it was so loud. It's kind of like if you heard an earthquake.
Just feet from the intersection of Donovan and Miller, where these two vehicles collided, Carol Gantis was fast asleep in her bed.
It was enough to wake you up. Anybody should have been awake by then.
The big boom caused by this impact when a black Dodge sedan eastbound on Donovan slammed into a white Jeep headed north on Miller.
As a result of the collision, two occupants of one of the vehicles had been ejected onto the roadway.
One of the Jeep's passengers died, the other now in critical condition, and the driver of the white Jeep also died in the crash.
The scene is huge. The speeds at which the collision occurred were quite high, so debris was scattered throughout the area.
Police say the driver of the black sedan, Javier Artemio Cortez, was under the influence of alcohol at the time, and further investigation revealed he was at fault.
When people are drunk or doing drugs and they're driving at all hours, you know, it's all over.
For several hours Saturday, several blocks of this busy street shut down as crime scene investigators combed the area. They're also reviewing surveillance footage captured by neighborhood cameras.
Some of the details leading up to the crash were captured on camera.
I'm told surveillance footage does show other motorists moving through the area right before and after the collision. Police are now hoping to speak with any witness. In the newsroom, I'm Asia Gore, KSBY News.
We'll be following. Thank you, Asia. The names of the victims have not been released, but we're told the two deceased are women ages 18 and 20. The driver was booked at the Santa Barbara County Jail on charges of DUI and vehicular manslaughter.